This weekend, the National Association of Music Merchants, known as NAM, kicks off their summer show at the Music City Center. A part of the fun is a music competition classified as an extreme sport. New at 10, our own Rebecca Schleicher got a taste of what competitors go through to become the world's fastest drummer.
Yeah, Rory, and it wasn't just me. They expect 300 people to actually compete this weekend, but only two will take home the title along with a championship belt.
Making music? An extreme sport. People take up the sticks to test their hands and feet, competing for the championship belt that goes only to the world's fastest drummer. You don't have to be a musician.
And we kind of practiced for about 10 or 15 seconds before we got on stage, so.
But the best usually have many hours of experience behind a drum set.
Brandon from California.
Good going, Brandon.
Tom Grosset holds the world record as the world's fastest drummer. He shows us how he hit more than 1,200 strokes in 60 seconds.
It's about being relaxed and then breathing and kind of almost meditating.
The drumometer ticks up with every stroke as the seconds tick down. It was developed here in Nashville by Boo McAfee.
Before that, when you said world's fastest drummer, it was very subjective matter. Like, oh yeah, how do you know?
For the demonstration, we put 10 seconds on Tom's clock.
Whoa, 186 in 10 seconds. Do the math.
Pretty impressive, and he agrees to walk me through it.
The thing is, we want to stick to single strokes, which are just right, left, right. You can go any volume you want. Just make sure it's one stroke per half.
Okay, 10 seconds on the clock. Let's see what I can do.
I never knew 10 seconds could last so long.
Are we still going?
It's good fun, but also a way to make music accessible.
And it gives, I think, young kids an incentive to practice their rudiments and get them excited about it, you know?
Sharing the love of a good beat with anyone who braves the stage.
Well, as parents know, it can be tough to get the kids to practice their instruments for the many hours needed, but those involved say competitions like this can help bring the fun back to practice. And I can tell you, I have a much greater appreciation for the people who are going to bring home that title for hands and feet this year.
Serious coordination. It's a good workout, too.
And I'm just glad I didn't embarrass myself.
No, you did great. Thanks, Rebecca. The World's Fastest Drummer Finals. They kick off at 2 o'clock tomorrow at the Music City Center. It is open to the public with a day ticket as part of NAMM's Industry Day, so check it out.